कहानी पग पग प्यारे
दंगल 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 दंगल
सूरज तेरा चढ़ता ढलता गर्दिश में करते हैं तारे
दंगल 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 दंगल।
ग्रेट मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, भूपेश आनंद। We are doing quantitative methods, and within that, a session named as quantitative methods application. And within that, we have four readings: common probability distribution, sampling, hypothesis testing, and technical analysis. And I am doing common probability distribution. Today is lecture number two. I have already taken lecture number one, and in lecture number one, I have covered learning outcome number A, learning outcome number B, learning outcome number C. And learning outcome number D. So I have covered four learning outcomes. So today I will be discussing with something more than that, and I will be covering two learning outcomes, E and F, because they have an interconnection. That's why I'm taking along with that. So please take out your registers. Today's lecture will be on binomial distribution or Bernoulli distribution. So great morning, quantitative methods, applications, common probability distribution, lecture number two. And within that lecture, I'm doing two learning outcomes, learning outcome number E and learning outcome number F. So my dear friends, in the last lecture, just see what we have to cover in this learning outcome number E. So as per CFA curriculum level number one, learning outcome number E means, which we have to discuss today, is what is the meaning or define discrete uniform random variable. Second is define binomial random variable. And third is define Bernoulli random variable. It means in today's lecture, I will be telling you three random variables. There are different types of nature of the variables, There are different types of distributions we have seen in the last lecture, that we have different types of variables, discrete data set, continuous data set. Within discrete, we can have uniform data set, we can have non-uniform data set. Within continuous, we can have uniform data set, we can have non-uniform data set. And then within that, we can play the games. So learning outcome number E, discrete uniform random variable. I suppose that in the last lecture we have discussed discrete uniform, discrete non-uniform. And I have already told you the example of, if I throw a dice, then what is the probability of getting one number, two number, three number, four number, five number, six number? That probability is 1/6, 1/6, 1/6, 1/6, 1/6, 1/6. That is uniform. You getting my point? And similarly, I have told you that, the example of discrete non-uniform, that attendance in the class, for a particular Monday, on Monday there is a high attendance as compared to on Saturday or Friday. That is discrete and that is non-uniform. When the data is concentrated on a particular month or a particular day or a particular point, that is non-uniform. So my dear friends, I have already discussed discrete uniform. So just write on the example discrete uniform. Just to remember, if I throw a dice, then the probability of getting any number is 1/6, 1/6, 1/6, and 1/6. So today I will be telling you about binomial random variable. And when I say binomial, it is BI. And when I see the dictionary meaning of BI, it is 2. So I will be discussing with binomial distribution or binomial random variable. And then after that, I will be touching with Bernoulli random variable. Again, the word is B. If you are clear with binomial, it is very easy to understand Bernoulli, because Bernoulli is a part of, binomial only. So firstly, we will understand what is binomial distribution. And once we are aware that what is binomial distribution, we can get aware that what is binomial random variable. So please take out your register, my dear sir. Learning outcome number F today will be starting with, we are also calculating the probabilities of given discrete uniform function and binomial distribution function. My dear friend, I have already told you how to calculate the probability in the last lecture, that is in one, how to calculate the probability of a discrete function. If the function is a discrete one, how to calculate it? That is a simple probability which we have calculated, and how to calculate the probability in case of binomial distribution function. So I will be dealing with that, and no doubt, this binomial tree, or I will say binomial method, or I will say binomial distribution, or I will say binomial random variable. It means we have two outcomes. For example, if I do an event, if I play a match, if I set for exams, either I will be successful or unsuccessful. There cannot be a third option. If I play a cricket match, either I will win or I will lose. There cannot be a third option. So if there are only two outcomes, if there are only two variables, either pass or success, there cannot be anything other than that. By that I mean by. And binomial distribution has the most important feature that it has only two outcomes. Success or not success. Winning or not winning. Yes or no. So first point which you have to write down is, what is the meaning of a binomial distribution? Because you should know what are the features of that. In the last lecture, we have discussed probability distribution. When I say probability distribution, it can be simple or it can be complex. When I say simple, it means it is uniform and discrete. And when I say complex, it means it is continuous and non-uniform. And I have told you that we will be mainly dealing with continuous and non-uniform. Normal distribution, we have seen the features of the normal distribution. Still in the next lectures, I will be telling you what is the features of the normal distribution. So we are focusing on what can be the different types of distributions we can have and what are the features of that. If I know the features of idli, if I know the feature of a pizza, then I can, you know, identify it by closing my eyes also. Just having a bite of pizza, I can say that this is pizza, this is idli, this is sambar. So I should know what are the features of that, because I know the features of idli, then that's why I can determine that this is idli. Similarly, just see what is the meaning of binomial distribution. And what are the features of binomial distribution? It is a probability distribution for a discrete random variable. It is a probability distribution for a discrete, not for a continuous. This is very important. It is for a discrete. It means a discrete random variable is important and two possible outcomes are there. I repeat, it is a probability distribution. It is a probability distribution for a binomial random variable. It means it is a distribution for a variable which has two outcomes possible. Outcomes can be success, failure, yes, no, win, lose. So there can be two types of outcomes. The probability of success is constant for each trial. It means we will be having so many trials. And in all the trials, the probability of one event, because there are only two outcomes, the probability of one outcome will be constant and it is independent of any other event. So let us start with, in case you are not getting anything, no point to worry that. I will be telling you with the help of a case study that what is the meaning of binomial distribution. What I mean by binomial random variables. Why I am telling that there are two variables. My dear friends, in the derivative chapter, we have options. In case you have already done the derivative, then the next 5 minutes will be very much comfortable to you. Or in case you have not done the derivative, just listen to me properly. That in case of derivative, we have option, and option can be of two types, call option and put option. When I say call option or put option, I have a right and obligation to buy. It means I have a right to buy, I can buy. For example, I have taken a call option on a stock. It means I have a right to buy, I can buy that at a particular price. That is a call option. In that we have current market price, we have strike price, we have, you know, we have maturity period and we have option premium. So the point is, how much should be the option premium? Which holder should pay to the writer, at least how much it should be. So that is named as pricing of option. And option pricing, you know, can be calculated with the help of a binomial distribution, because it has two variables. It has binomial variables. That is, either the spot price on maturity will go high, go up as compared to strike price, or the spot price on maturity will go down. So there are two variables possible. Now, whether it will go up or down, it depends upon the volatility, that how volatility that stock has. You know, that depends upon the risk and that depends upon the uptick factor or downtick factor. These two factors I will be telling you in detail in derivatives, just to relate, you know, the binomial distribution or binomial random variable. I am taking the help of derivatives. Within derivative, I am taking the help of a call option. So just see the case study which I want to tell you. Suppose there is a call option. Now, I think that you must be aware of what is the call option. Call option is a right to buy an underlying asset. Supposedly, Ramlal has a call option on a stock. It means he can buy that stock at a strike price of 70. Please write down this case study because this will only clear your concepts. Supposedly, the strike price is $70 and the current market price is $100. Current market price is $100 and there are two outcomes possible on the maturity date. Either the spot price will increase or the spot price will decrease. Now, by how much it will increase, we can calculate it with the help of an uptick factor. And by how much it will decrease, we can calculate it with the help of downtick factor. Now, we have so many difficult complex formulas to calculate uptick or downtick, but no need to worry. Nothing you have to remember, nothing you have to learn, nothing you have to cram. You know? Only the intention is to see the logic. My dear friends, in today's lecture number 2, in common probability distribution, I am on learning outcome E and F. And I will be telling you what is the meaning of discrete random variable, which I have already told you in the last lecture. So today my focus will be on binomial distribution, binomial random variable. When I say binomial, I mean two. I mean there are two outcomes possible. It means it is a discrete random variable. Discrete random binomial variable in which only two outcomes are possible, that is named as binomial distribution. So in binomial distribution, in order to explain that how two outcomes are possible, I am taking the help of option valuation methods. That is how to calculate the price of an option or what should be the price of that option if these are the numbers available. The first number which is available to me is call option. You know, call option of a stock is available. Strike price is $70 and the current market price is $100. And the two outcomes of the spot can be if spot price increases to $125 and if it decreases to $80. Now, how we have calculated that 125 or 80 depends upon the volatility of that stock, that how much risk it has. So, you know, so the point is, don't go in that how we have calculated 125 or 80. That I have told you in my PPT also. Just see the logic. That just is a tree which I am going to prepare. Now you know, current market price, I have written $100 and you are standing here. The current market price is $100. And the first point is it can increase. Now, or the price can decrease. Only there are two outcomes possible. Either the price will increase or the price will decrease. So it is a binomial distribution, and because a call option has two, you know, call option has two outcomes, that either it can increase or it will decrease on the expiry. So that's why I'm taking the help of call option pricing for explaining the binomial distribution by binomial random variables. Now, how I have calculated this 1.25, no need to worry, this is uptick factor. And how I have calculated 0.8, that is very easy, 1 upon 0.12, 0.25, you know, 1 upon reciprocal of uptick factor. Reciprocal of uptick factor is 0.8. So the point is, I have calculated that if the price can reach up to 125 or the price can come down to $80 after 1 year, if the period of maturity is 1 year, then whether the call holder will opt that or whether that call holder will lapse the option, if he exercises it, then how much is a profit? And what is the probability of getting that much profit? That we will discuss in detail at the time of option valuation models. I am taking the help of those models because I can relate it with the help of, so that you can get a better idea of binomial random variables. When I say buy, it means two. So I have prepared a tree. Please prepare for me. This I am standing here. Now the price can go up, the price can go down. Now how I have calculated 1.25, there is again a logic behind that. 1.25 uptick factor can be calculated by this formula. No need to learn this. We can easily calculate with the help of calculator. Just for understanding purpose, I have written that uptick factor is exponential raised to power standard deviation under the root t. Suppose, I have just assumed that suppose U is equal to 1.25, because we have not to deal with how U is to be calculated. I have just told you what is the meaning of a U, because it will help me in understanding the concept of binomial tree or binomial distribution or binomial random variable. Suppose U is 1.25, that is uptick factor. It means the if the price increases, then it will increase up to 1.25. It means if the current market price is $100, then it will increase to $125. And if uptick factor is 1.25, then downtick factor is 1 upon 1.25, that will be 0.8. And it means $100 stock can decrease the price up to $80. So just see, suppose uptick factor is 1.25. It implies if stock increases, then it will increase by 25%. So that comes to 1.25. And 0.8 is a downtick factor. D is equal to 1 upon U. That is 1 upon 1.25. That is 0.8. It implies if the stock decreases, it will decrease by 20%. So I have prepared, I have taken the help of binomial model. I have taken the help of option pricing. I have taken the help of call option, because in that I can easily fit the binomial model, because there are two outcomes. Either it will happen or it will not happen. And what is the probability of, how much uptick factor will be there? It depends upon the volatility of the stock. Now the point is, after understanding the concept that how I have calculated $125 and $80. Now the point is, what is the probability that it will increase to $125, and what is the probability that it will decrease to $80? It means $100 current price, what is the probability that it will increase to 125, and what is the probability that it will decrease to 180? Again, we have a huge formula, but there is no need to learn it. Just see, I have explained in detail in derivatives that how this formula has been derived. 1 plus RF, because we are on the basis of risk neutral assumption that he can borrow from risk free and without any risk. So 1 plus RF R minus D upon U minus D. How it is derived, I have given the whole logic in my derivative lecture. Just for this, for a moment, just assume that you have understood how to calculate probability, how to calculate U, how to calculate D, and after calculating P, I can calculate 1 minus P. Just see, if P, the probability of increase is 60%, then it automatically means that probability of decrease will be 40%, because only there are two outcomes. That's why it is named as binomial. So, Now just listen to me. When prices increases to 125 and the strike price is $70. So the point is, whether if you are a call holder, if the strike price is $70 and the price here is $125, whether you will buy it from the market or whether you will buy it from the writer, it is but important that you will buy from the writer, because you will be having a profit of $55, because the same asset is available at $125 in the market. It means you can sell it in the market by purchasing it from the writer. You have a right to buy it from the writer at $70, and you can sell in the market at $125. It means directly you can have a profit of $55. So if this is the scenario, that if the prices increases, if the price increases, then you have a profit of $55. Similarly, if the price decreases to $80, then also you will exercise it, because the exercise price is $70. Strike price is $70. It is a case of call in the money, because you will opt it. You will have a profit of $10. And this profit of $10, again, I have just given the calculation, just see to it. In scenario 2, when price decreases to 80, because there are two options. One is uptick factor, that is 125. Second is downtick factor. With the help of that, I have calculated $80. He will exercise the option and the profit will be $10. So expected value, Now, in this branch, we have a profit of $55. And in this branch, we have a profit of $10. And if the probability of this branch is 60%, if the probability of this branch is 40%, and supposingly I have understood that how to calculate that probability and how to calculate U and D, then I can calculate the value here, that what should be the value of this option, or that is named as price of an option, or then we can compare it with premium which is there in the market. So just see, $37. Okay. So $55 into 60% plus $10 into 40%, that comes to $37. It means the price of this call option after 1 year will be $37. But I am standing here at T0. I want to find out that how much should be the option premium, at least which call holder should pay to the call writer. So I will discount that 37 to today's term. I will calculate the present value of that, and supposing the time value factor is 15%, then I have calculated that that comes to 32 point this much. It means this much dollars, 32.17 dollars should be the call option price at T0 of this stock. If the current market price is $100, if the strike is $70, and if the up price can be $125, and if the down price can be $80. If these are the facts, then this should be the price. But if actual premium is more than that, then you know we can have arbitrage opportunities. I'm not going in that I have already told you in derivatives. So my dear friends, please be attentive for the coming 5 minutes. I have just discussed what is the meaning of binomial random variable. Binomial random variable is that type of variable which is discrete in nature, and the outcome is that which is discrete in nature, discrete random variable, and the outcome is only two. Two outcomes are possible, yes or no. Success or failure, win or lose, not third option is possible. So this is named as binomial distribution. Now, binomial tree, which we have discussed, I have discussed it up to one period. We can extend to two period also, which I have told you in derivatives, that how it can be extended to two periods. So please write on second point, binomial tree. This is a tree which I have prepared. This is a tree which I have prepared for you. This is a tree. It is just like a tree. Now it can be prepared for second year period also. So just see, write down second point, that binomial tree can be for one period binomial tree, or it can be two period binomial tree. Now, when it is two period, it means for second attempt also. So this is up to this point, one period, and here two period. So from 0 to 1, one period, then 1 to 2 is two period. Just see the tree and please prepare it and see how I have prepared it. Very easy. The spot price here is, I can say S here is $100. So first I have calculated S into U, that is spot price at T0 into uptick factor, spot price at T0 into downtick factor. If this is possible in first year, then in second year again the price can increase or price can decrease. If it can increase, if it will increase, then SU, because this is SU, spot price to uptick into uptick for second period, spot price into uptick into D for second period downtick. So I have done it for you. SUU, SUD, SDU, SDD. The probability is 0.6, 0.4, 0.6, 0.4. And I have calculated 156.25. Please see how I have calculated 1.65. Again, multiply 125 with 1.25. $125 with 1.25, I will calculate 156.25. If I multiply 125 with 0.8, because downtick factor is 0.8, I will be doing it $100. Again, the same concept will be here. And please write down SUU, SUD, SDU, SDD. Again, the point is, if I want to calculate the probability, I can calculate with the help of a joint probability, which I have told you in derivatives also, what is the meaning of joint probability, and in the probability grading also, that what I mean by joint, if this and this, because I can reach at second branch if first branch happens. So probability of first branch into probability of second branch, and the probability of first branch is 60%, probability of second branch is 60%. So the joint probability is 36%, probability of first branch is 60%, probability of second branch is 40%. So the joint probability is 24%. Similarly, I have calculated 24%, 16%, and the total is 100%. You're getting a point. So total is 100%. So I have just told you what is the meaning of binomial. I think you must have be aware now that how or why or what are the methods or what are the features of a binomial random variable or a distribution, and how we can calculate it. It is a discrete binomial variable. It a data set which has a discrete random bivariables. That is those variables which have only two outcomes possible. That is named as, is named as a binomial random variable, or that distribution is named as binomial distribution. So my dear friends, you should be aware of what are the features of normal distribution, because with the help of just data set, I can say it is a normal distribution. With the help of a data set, I can say it is a binomial distribution. With the help of data set, I can say it is a chi-square distribution. With the help of normal set, I can say it is a Z distribution. So I should be aware of the features of all the distributions. So after completing with binomial distribution and the probability, that how to calculate the probability, because I have mixed learning outcome number E and F. In learning outcome number E, they have told that what is the meaning of binomial distribution, and in F, how to calculate the probability and interpretation of the binomial distribution. So I have told you how I can calculate probability for first year period or for second year period. And now I am to the last concept, that is Bernoulli distribution. Please write down Bernoulli. Now this Bernoulli distribution is a part of binomial distribution only. I will say when I want to have exact number of success, or exact number, if the word is exact given to you, that how much is the probability out of this that I will get exact this much, exact 4, exact 3. Different outcomes are given to you. Different experiments are given to you. Different trials are there. Out of that trials, how much is the probability that I will get this much number? That exact word is named as Bernoulli distribution. So please write down a point. A binomial random variable for which the number of trial is 1. We generally have a lower number of trials. It is named as Bernoulli random variable. Think of a variable that this variable is a very mini experiment. B point. Bernoulli distribution will have one word which is very important, that is named as exact. So if the word exact is given, it means I am using Bernoulli distribution, but it is again, you know, a part of binomial. When I say binomial, two possible outcomes, either pass or fail, either success or not success. So in that two variables, if I want the exact number, then I will be using Bernoulli distribution. Suppose a team is ready to play 10 cricket match. Calculate the probability of winning exactly 4 matches. Now it can be possible in so many different ways. Win, not win, fail, or it can also be happen like this: win, fail. There can be different types of combinations with that. I will be telling you how to calculate the probability. Just write down firstly B point. Bernoulli distribution will have one word which is named as exact. Suppose a team is ready to play 10 cricket matches, then out of that probability, what is the probability of getting exactly 4 matches? So it means, because I am using the word exactly, so I will be using Bernoulli. Bernoulli distribution will always be used when we are dealing with binomial set of data. This is very important, because it is a part of binomial only. When I say binomial, it means there are two outcomes, two discrete random variables. So when we have two discrete random variables, and within that we want to calculate exact number as a probability, then I will say I will be using Bernoulli distribution. Success, failure, win, lose, yes, no. So following is a formula for calculating, you know, this complicated formula. Just write down, there is no need to learn it. I will be telling you a simple technique. With the help of that, we can calculate. I have even given the modified formula. This you have to write down. The number of attempts, combination. I have told you what is the meaning of a combination and probability in the last lecture. We can use combination, NCR. The button is there in the calculator. Number of attempts, combination, number of success events into probability of success, raised to power number of success events into probability of failures, raised to power number of failed attempts. Again, I am not telling you the intent behind this. Very easy. Firstly, we will be doing with one case study, and then I will be explaining you how I can, you know, learn it and how I can get the intent of this formula. Just please focus for coming 2 minutes in this case study. Out of 10 cricket matches, the same example which I have just told you, that there are 10 cricket matches. What is the probability of winning exact 4? It means when I use 4, then it means it is I will be using Bernoulli distribution, and when I say match, there are two outcomes possible, either I will win or lose. It means it is a case of binomial distribution, and within binomial I want an exact number. It means I will be using Bernoulli distribution, and the probability of winning is 70% and the probability of not winning is 30%. Then I can calculate like this: 10C4, total number of matches, combination of 4, I want to win 4, into probability of winning raised to power number of, the probability of success, that is 70%, raised to power number of success events, 4, the probability of success is 70, so I have multiplied 70, 4 times, because I want to get success 4 times, into probability of not getting success, 30, raised to power of not getting success, that is 6, so that's why I have multiplied 6 times. So if I solve it, I can calculate 3.67%. Now this I have already told you that how we can calculate with the help of calculator, so I'm not going in that. So 3.67% is the probability that I will be exactly winning 4 matches out of those 10 matches if the probability of winning is 70% and if the probability of not winning is 30%. So let's have a practical example in this Bernoulli distribution. So I repeat, I am discussing binomial distribution and Bernoulli distribution. Bernoulli distribution is possible only if binomial is existing, because Bernoulli is a part of binomial. But in Bernoulli, we are concerned with exact number. So just see the example in case you can do. The probability of passing exactly 2, again the word exactly 2 is mentioned. Out of 6 trials, it means I have to lose the Bernoulli distribution. If the probability of passing is 20%, then probability of not passing is 60%. Very simple, 6CR, that is total number of matches, out of that 6CR, R means the number of matches we want to win, into 0.20%, 20% is the probability of success, 2 times we want to win, 80% is the probability of not success, 4 times we will not win, and that comes to 24.57. So the point is very easy, no need to worry, We will be understanding this logic intent also. We'll just firstly write down the last point, then I will be telling you something more. How to calculate mean? I have just told you what is the meaning of binomial, what is the meaning of Bernoulli, how we can calculate probability. Now the last point is how to calculate the mean of binomial distribution and variance of binomial distribution. So if I am aware of how to calculate mean and variance of binomial distribution, I can calculate for Bernoulli also. Every distribution will have a defined mean and a defined variance, that we are all aware of, whether it is a binomial distribution, whether it is a normal distribution, whether it is a skewed distribution, whether it is negatively distributed, whether it is positively distributed, it has a mean and a variance. Mean of this distribution is n into p, and the variance is n into p into q. Mean is n into p, how I have calculated I will be telling you, and the variance is n into p into q, and q is equal to 1 minus p. Now let us do a case study on the basis of which I can say that this is the mean, this is the process of calculating mean, and this is the process of calculating variance. If the probability of winning match is 70% and total number of matches are 10, again the same example which I have just told you. So the mean will be number of matches 10 into 70%, that is n into p, that comes to 7, and the variance will be 10 into 70% into q. So just see, 10 into 70 into 30, that comes to 2.1. My dear friends, I'm again telling you that please write along with me, please prepare class notes as I am preparing it, because I have prepared the slides for you. No need, there will be no benefit if you are just listening to these lectures, because these are somewhat technical part and we will be going to more technical in coming lectures. Common probability distribution is a basic, foundation of sampling and hypothesis testing. So you should be aware of what is the meaning of probability distribution, how we can represent it, what is probability density function. In the last lecture, cumulative probability distribution. Now in this lecture, I have told you that binomial distribution, Bernoulli distribution, how to distinguish that this is Bernoulli and how to see that this is binomial. So by the end of this reading, you will be able to distinguish normal distribution, you will be able to distinguish Bernoulli distribution, binomial distribution, and all Poisson distribution, chi-square distribution, Z distribution, T distribution. So you should know what is the meaning, what are the features of these. Hope you are enjoying it. So just see, Google Baba, I have given some examples. I have seen this Bernoulli distribution. Just see, there are two outcomes because it is a part of binomial. So either success or not success, either success or not success, and within that, you know, within that we want to find out the exact number, then I will be using this Bernoulli. And if I see binomial distribution as per Wikipedia, binomial distribution, it is a random variable which has, you know, two outcomes, yes or no. Just see the binomial distribution. Probability, the binomial distribution with parameter n and p is a discrete. It is not a continuous. It is a discrete probability distribution of the number of successes in a sequence of n independent events, each asking a yes or no question, in which with I can this. Be happy, be really, be cheerful.